Hello, I am your tutor, Mrs. Hima Rajesh. Today, in animals. And before we get into the lesson, I would like to access the website, the revision notes, and the test in clay6.com. Go to clay6.com, click on practice. So you will be getting a lot of packages. You can select, since it's a NEET class, I'm selecting NEET premium package. Yeah, here you will see a lot of tests in physics, chemistry, and biology with NEET full tests. And all these tests are chapter-wise tests. So if we click on biology 11th, because we are doing, you see a lot of colored bubbles. Each colored bubble represents a test. A green bubble represents that you have already completed the test. But you can also revisit the test if you want to improve your scores or if you want to do a revision. A blue bubble shows that you have not taken the test. Yellow bubble shows that you have not completed the test. Sometimes you might have started the test, and after 4 to 5 questions, you would have felt that you are not prepared adequately, and so you want to quit the test. And once you have learned all the concepts, you can visit the test again and complete the test. Now you see each and every chapter has different number of tests. It depends upon the complexity of the lesson and also its importance in the NEET. And that is why the tests are also many, or in a few, it might be a few tests. Here, if you look at all the bubbles over here, now if you have completed all the tests, you can then go to the randomized test, which is shown in the red color. And this red bubble, if you click on take the test, it will help you to revise, and it will also help you to analyze your own preparations. Now, if you have done this, you just click on the revision notes, then it will open into a PDF chapter, which I'm going to talk about it. Now, before we really begin with our lessons, I'm sure you all will be wondering about your upcoming NEET exams, and you might want to know how the NEET papers are really going to be. You be relaxed. In biology, especially with our analysis, we have found if you are prepared with NCERT thoroughly, you can answer 68 to 70 questions very easily. And if you have done the past year's papers, you can score another 8 to 10 questions that feature from the past papers, either directly with little or no modifications, you can straight away get. And around 8 to 10 questions will be new questions, and they become the game changers. Because if you have just mucked up the concepts, it is of no use. You need to understand how the concept and how to apply those concepts. That is why we have made an earnest attempt in this website to help you to prepare adequately for all the three kinds of the questions. And that is how we have designed our test. And hence, I would suggest you go for this package. Now, let us look into the today's lesson. With this framework, I'm getting back into today's lesson, structural organization in animals. So, you know, a tissue is a group of cells along with intercellular substances performing a specific function. Now, animal tissues are classified broadly into four types: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and neural tissue. Now, let us look at epithelial tissues. Now, simple epithelial. Epithelial tissue is the tissues that are composed of simple epithelium tissues are composed of single layer of cells, and they function as the lining for body cavities, ducts, and tubes. Now, the cells are compactly packed with little or no intercellular, with very little intercellular matrix. There are two kinds of epithelial tissue. One is the simple epithelium tissue, and other is the compound epithelium tissue. Now, if you look at these diagrams, these are very important, and we have summarized it very easily for you to understand in a form of a table. Now, let us look at squamous epithelium. It is made up of single layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. It occurs in the walls of blood vessels and air sacs of lungs. It forms a diffusion boundary. Now, cuboidal epithelium is composed of single layer of cube-like cells. They are commonly found in the ducts of the glands and tubular parts of the nephrons in the kidney. And the main functions of cuboidal epithelium are absorption and secretion. Epithelium of proximal convoluted tubule of nephron of kidney has microvilli. Now, columnar epithelium, if you look at it, as the name suggests itself, the cells will be column-like. They are single layer of tall and slender cells. Nuclei is located at the base. It is found in the lining of the stomach and the intestine. It helps in secretion and absorption. Now, ciliated epithelium. If the columnar cells are made up of cilia, if they have cilia on the free surface, they form the ciliated epithelium. The function is to move the particles or mucus in a particular direction over the epithelium. It is present on the inner surface of the organs like bronchioles and fallopian tubes. Now, this is about the simple epithelium. Now, let us look at the compound epithelium. Compound epithelium is made up of more than one layer of cells. They provide protection against chemical and mechanical stresses. They are found to cover areas of the skin, moist cavity, pharynx, inner lining of salivary glands, and pancreatic ducts. Now let us look at the compound epithelium. This is the compound epithelium. So here you find they are multi-layered cells. Now if we are looking at the next one will be the glandular epithelium. Certain columnar or cuboidal cells get special secretion forming the glandular epithelium. They are of two types. One is the unicellular glandular cells and multicellular cells. Unicellular cells are isolated glandular cells. Example, goblet cells of the elementary canal. And if you look at the multicellular cells, they consist of cluster of cells like salivary glands. Now, based upon the presence of ducts or without ducts, they are classified as exocrine gland and endocrine gland. Now, let us look at the connective tissue. So, connective tissues, as the name suggests, because of the special, they have a special function of linking and supporting other tissues or organs of the body. Now, they range from soft connective tissue to specialized cells, cartilage, bone, adipose, and blood. These are all the examples of connective tissues. All connective tissues except blood vessels secrete fibers of structural proteins called collagen and elastin. Fibers provide strength, elasticity, and flexibility to the tissue. Cells also secrete modified polysaccharides that accumulate between the cells and fibers, acting as a ground substance. Now, they are classified into three types, that is, loose connective tissue and connective tissue. Now, what you are seeing on this slide is a loose connective tissue. Areolar and adipose tissues are the examples. Areolar tissue, these cells and fibers are loosely arranged in a semi-fluid ground substance or the matrix. Areolar tissue serves as a transport framework for epithelium. It contains fibroblasts, macrophages, and mast cells. Adipose tissue, another loose connective tissue, is located mainly in the fat. Excess nutrients are not used immediately, which are not used immediately, are converted into fat and are stored in the adipose tissue. Now let us look at dense connective tissue. In dense connective tissue, fibers and fibroblasts are arranged compactly. Orientation of the fibers show a regular and irregular pattern, and hence they are classified as dense regular connective tissue and dense irregular connective tissue. In regular connective tissues, the collagen fibers are present between many parallel bundles of fibers. Tendons that connect to skeletal muscles, to bones, and ligaments which connect one bone to bone is an example. Now, if you look at the special connective tissues, you will find cartilage, bone, and the blood. Now, cartilage, the intercellular material of cartilage is soft and pliable. It can resist compression. Chondrocytes are enclosed in small cavities within the matrix. Now, most of the cartilages in vertebrate embryos are replaced by bones in adults. Cartilage occurs in the tip of nose, outer ear joints, between bones of vertebral column, limbs, and hands in adults. Now, if you look at bone, they have a hard and non-pliable ground substance. They are rich in calcium salts and collagen fibers that gives bones its strength. It's a main tissue which is going to give you providing the support and a structural framework to the body. Bones will support and protect the softer tissues and organs. Bone cells, which are also called as osteocytes, are present in spaces called the lacunae. Bone marrow in the bones is the site of production of the blood cells. Now let us look into blood cells. That is the blood. You know, blood is the chief fluid connecting tissue. It contains RBCs, WBCs, and platelets. It is the main circulating fluid that helps in transport of many substances. More details about the blood you will be studying in the lesson circulatory system, wherein body fluids and circulation, you will be learning more about this. Now let us look at the muscle tissue. So the muscle tissues, you can find the diagrams here, made up of long cylindrical, they are made up of long cylindrical fibers and parallel arrays. Now fibers are composed of numerous fine fibrils called myofibrils. Muscle fibers contract in response to stimulation, then relax and return to their uncontracted state in a coordinated fashion. Their action will enable us to adjust to the changes in the environment and to maintain positions of various parts of the body. Now there are three kinds of muscles. One is the skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and the cardiac muscle. Skeletal muscles are closely attached to the skeletal bones. In a typical muscle, striated muscle fibers are bundled together in a parallel fashion. A sheath of tough connective tissue encloses several bundles of muscle fibers, and since it appears striations appear, they are also called as striated muscles. Now, if you look at the smooth muscles, they taper at both the ends and do not show any striations. Cell junctions hold them together in a connective tissue sheath. Smooth muscles are involuntary as their functions cannot be controlled directly. Example, walls of blood vessels, stomach and intestine. And the last one is the cardiac tissue, that is the cardiac muscles. Contractile protein is present only in the heart. Now contractile tissue, sorry, not protein, contractile tissue is present only in the heart. Cell junctions fuse the plasma membrane of the cardiac muscle cells. Communication junctions at some fusion points allow the cell to contract as a unit. Since I'm talking about cell junctions, let me briefly tell you, there are three types of cell junctions. One is the tight junction, which helps to stop the substance from leaking across a tissue. Adhering junctions perform cementing function to keep the neighboring cells together, and gap junctions facilitate the cells to communicate with each other by connecting the cytoplasm of adjoining cells for rapid transfer of ions, small molecules, and sometimes big molecule. Now, the fourth kind of tissue we are supposed to learn is the neural tissue. These are the functional units and excitable cells. Neuroglia cells make more than half the volume of the neural tissue, and they protect and support the neurons. Now let us look, what are neurons? Are they neural system or excitable cells? An electrical disturbance is generated when a neuron is suitably stimulated that travels swiftly along its plasma membrane. Arrival of the disturbance at neurons ending or output zone triggers events that may cause stimulation or inhibition of adjacent neurons and other cells. So with this, we have learned about the four kinds of animal tissues. Now, though in your textbook, you have got about frog, earthworm, and all those stuff, from knee point of view, that is not there for your exams. Only, that is Periplaneta americana, only cockroach is there for the examination, and it is very, very important. Now, let us look into the external features of the cockroach. So, you know, cockroach belongs to the class Insecta. Cockroach It belongs to the class Insecta of phylum Arthropoda. It is bright red, yellow, and green colored cockroaches can be seen in tropical regions. They range in size from 1/4 inch to 3 inches and have a long antenna, legs, and flat extension of the upper body wall that conceals the head. They are nocturnal omnivores and are serious pests, and they also are the vectors for several diseases like gastroenteritis or salmonella bacteria. Now, if we look at the morphology of a cockroach, the common species is Periplaneta americana. They are said to be about 34 to 53 millimeters long with wings that extend beyond the tip of the abdomen in males. Now, body is divided into three regions: head, thorax, and the abdomen. Entire body is covered by a hard chitinous exoskeleton called sclerites. Dorsal scales are called the pterygoids, and the ventral scale are called the sternites, and they are joined to each other by thin and flexible articular membrane. Now, if we look at the head of the cockroach, it is triangular in shape and lies anteriorly at right angles to the body axis. It is formed by the fusion of 6 segments and shows a great motility in all the directions due to a flexible neck. Head bears a pair of compound eyes. A pair of thread-like antennae arises from membranous sockets lying in front of the eyes. Antennae have sensory receptors that help in sensing the environment. Mouth parts are of chewing and biting type. Mouth parts consist of labrum, a pair of mandibles, a pair of maxilla, a hypopharynx lies within the cavity enclosed by the mouth parts. So this diagram is very important. That's why I have projected it as a slide for you. Please note all these things, which is hypopharynx, labrum, mandible, maxilla, labium, and all these things they might ask you for identification. Now let us get back to the thorax part. Thorax has got 3 parts. One is the prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. Neck connects the head to the prothorax. Each thoracic segment bears a pair of walking legs, and hence it has 6 legs. The first pair of wings arises from mesothorax and second pair from the metathorax, and so they have 4 wings altogether. 4 wings are oblique, dark, and leathery, and cover the hind wings at rest. Hind wings are transparent, membranous, and they are used for flight. Now, if you look at the abdomen, in both males and females have 10 segments. In females, the 7th sternum is boat shaped, and together with 8th and 9th sterna forms a brood pouch or genital pore that contains female gonopore, spermatheca pores, and collateral. Glands. In males, genital divided into 3 regions: foregut, midgut, gut. Foregut, the mouth opens into a short, leading to a narrow tubular passage called esophagus. Esophagus will open into a sac-like structure called crop, which is used for storing the food. Now the crop is followed by a sac-like structure, and this is called followed by the gizzard or lower ventriculus. Gizzard has an outer layer of thick circular muscles and thick inner cuticle forming 6 highly chitinous plates that help in grinding and crushing the food. Gizzard helps in grinding the food particles. Entire foregut is lined by the cuticle. Now the next one is the midgut here. At the junction of the foregut and midgut, a ring of 6 to 8 tubules called hepatic cecae or gastric cecae is present that secrete the digestive juice. Now at the hindgut, if you see, at the junction of the midgut and hindgut, you will find another 100 to 150 finger-like projections, and these are called as the malphigian tubules. These help in the removal of excretory products from the hemolymph. Hindgut is broader than midgut, and it is differentiated into ileum. The rectum opens out through the anus. Now let us look at the circulatory system. The blood vessels are poorly developed and open into space, and this is called as the hemocele. Visceral organs located in the hemocele are bathed in the blood and the blood is called the hemolymph. Hemolymph is composed of colorless plasma and hematocytes. Heart is elongated muscular tube lying along the mid-dorsal line of thorax and abdomen. It is differentiated into funnel-shaped chambers with ostia on either sides. Blood from the sinuses will enter the heart through the ostia and it is pumped anteriorly to the sinuses again. Now this diagram, respiratory system, you don't have it in your book, but in old NEET papers, if you see, they have asked about the respiratory system, and that's why I have put this slide. At least they might ask you what it is and I ask you to identify. You should be able to say it is a spiracle, trachea and tracheoles. Now, respiratory system comprises of a network of trachea that opens through 10 pairs of small tubes called spiracles that are present on the lateral side of the body. Thin branching tubes, that is tracheal tubes divided into tracheoles, carry oxygen from the air to all the body parts. Opening of the spiracle is regulated by the sphincter. Exchange of gases takes place at the tracheoles by diffusion. Now the next one is the excretion. This also in some of the papers they have asked. It is old book, but we do not know. In case you get, I thought I will show you what it is. Please remember this diagram. It is the Malpighian tubule. Each tubule is lined by glandular and ciliated cells. They absorb nitrogenous waste products and convert them into uric acid. Uric acid is excreted out through the hind gut. Hence, insects are also uricotelic. Fat body, nephrocytes, and uricose glands also help in excretion. Now, if you look at the nervous system, it consists of a series of fused, segmentally arranged ganglia joined by paired longitudinal connectives on the ventral side. Nervous system is spread throughout the body. Now let us look into the reproductive system. So reproductive system in cockroach is very well developed. Male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes lying each side in the fourth to sixth abdominal segment. From each testis arises a thin vas deferens, which opens into the ejaculatory duct through the seminal vesicle. The sperms are stored in the seminal vesicles and are glued together in the form of bundles called spermatophores, which are discharged during copulation. Now let us look into female reproductive system. It consists of large ovaries, as you see, lying laterally in the second to sixth abdominal segment. Oviducts of each ovary will unite into a single median oviduct, which opens into the genital chamber. The fertilized eggs are encased in capsules called oothecae. On an average, females produce 9 to 10 oothecae, each containing 14 to 16 eggs. Development is porometabolous, that means to say it goes through the nymphal stages. The nymph looks very much like the adults. Nymph will grow by molting about 13 times to reach the adult form. The next to last nymphal stage has wing pads, but only adult cockroaches have wings. Now, if you look at the economic importance of cockroach, they do not have any economic importance because they are pests and they destroy food and contaminate it with their smelly excreta and can spread bacterial diseases. So these are the key points of this lesson which you are expected to learn. Now with this, let us go and take a test. So a tissue is a group of similar cells that function together in a specialized activity. So that is the answer. What is not true about glial cells? Glial cells secrete neurotransmitters that facilitate synaptic transmission. That is wrong. A bone marrow is composed of adipose tissue, areolar tissue, and blood vessels. Epithelial tissues perform the following functions. They perform all the functions, so it is all of the above. Lamina propria is related to human intestine. The cells forming the peritoneal lining of the coelom comprises of simple squamous epithelium. Cells of squamous epithelium are flat plate-like. Epithelial tissue with thin flat cells appearing like tiled cells occur on the inner lining of the cheek. Epithelium which lines the inner surface of the stomach of man is made up of columnar epithelium. Which one of the following epithelial cells repair the injured cells? So, columnar cells. Ciliated epithelium is found on the fallopian tubes and nasal passages. I think I have left 11th one. The epithelium best adapted for body surface subject to abrasion is stratified squamous epithelium. The order to which Periplaneta americana belongs to is Orthoptera. Cockroach is an insect because it has six legs. How many segments form the head capsule of the cockroach? Six. So let me end the test. So all the answers are correct. So if you see, this is the legend. If everything is in green, it means all the answers are correct. If you see red color tail, that means it's an incorrect answer. And when you go and click on that, it will show your answer and also the correct answer. So that you will be, and with the explanation, it will be easier for you to understand your mistake. If you have not attempted the question, it will show an yellow color. And if you again click on that, you will get to know the explanation and also the answer for it. Now, since it is an entrance exam you're giving and it is all based on negative correction, if you're not sure of the answer, please do not click it. If you do it, you might, if you just don't try to guess your answers, and in your guessing might cost you very costly because you're going to lose one mark from your total. Now, with this, we come to the end of today's class. Test, that is, tutors have created the test taking into account all the different kinds of questions that may feature in your NEET exams, and 20 plus past NEET papers all solved with solutions. You can get additional help by using our ask feature on our site, and we support also the student chat group on our Telegram. If you want to have one-to-one tutoring with the teachers for any of the subjects or for any of the chapters, also, you can book the slots. For any queries if you have, you can always mail your query to info@clay6.com. Meet you all tomorrow. Thank you. Have a nice day.